Hi friends, welcome back to Smart Engineering Academy, myself Amit. So let me continue with the MCQs on moment distribution method. Okay, so I'll start solving the MCQs, which is most important, and it will clarify your doubts with respect to the concepts which I had explained in the previous lecture series. So in this question, they're asking us, calculate the final moments at the support of the continuous beam, which is shown in the figure. They have given on continuous beam. In this continuous beam, we need to calculate the final moment. Okay, so there are two types of moments which we are not supposed to get confused. One is fixed end moment and one is final moment. The question they're asking us to find final moment. To calculate the final moment, you need to start the procedure. The first procedure is you need to calculate the fixed end moment, then you need to calculate stiffness distribution factor. After calculating the distribution factor, by making use of the chart, by the iteration method, you can finally find the final moment. This is the procedure that need to be followed, and in the third procedure you're supposed to get the final moment. So as per the step is concerned, first step, to find the fixed end moment, let me calculate moment at a point, moment AB. Moment at a point AB will be minus WL square. Minus WL square divided by 12. What is the value of W? W is given 12, minus of 12 into what is the length? From A to B, the length is 4 meters divided by 12. Moment at a point AB is how much? It is minus 16 kilonewton meter. Okay, then moment BA, it will be plus WL square by 12. You will get moment at a point BA will be equal to 16 kilonewton meter. So next, moment at a point BC. Moment at a point BC, what is the standard formula with respect to this? See, this is in a condition that, I'll just write a condition like how the condition is going to look like. Moment. See, the 20 kilonewton point load from B to C, it is not exactly acting at the center. So, moment at a point BC will be equal to minus WAB square by L square. For all these cases, I have given the chart in the previous lecture series. What is the value of W? Minus 20 into what is the value of A? Let me take this as A for in case of BC. This is A and this is B. Minus 20 into 2 into 1 square divided by what is the L square? L square is 3 square. Moment at a point BC comes to be minus 4.4 kilonewton meter. Next, moment at a point CB. While calculating moment at the point CB, you need to consider again it is how much? Plus WA square B by L square. Let me take this as A and this as B as same. So what is W? W is 20 kilonewton into A is 2 square into 1. Here B is I am making B a square, but in this I am making A square. This chart is already given in the conceptual lecture series. So what is the value of L? Same thing, 3 square. If you calculate this, the moment at a point CB, it comes to be 8.89 kilonewton meter. Okay, these are the four things. First thing, second thing, third thing, and fourth thing, which is very important to calculate the final moment. Sometimes in the examination, they will ask, instead of final moment, they may ask fixed end moment of BC or fixed end moment of BA. You should be ready to answer. Next, so we have calculated the fixed end moment with respect to the first step. In the second step, I need to calculate the distribution factor. So I'm going into the second step. First, I'll draw a chart. Joint. How many joints are present here? There is only one joint present here at a point B. Joint connecting the members. I'm just writing it as members. Joint connecting the member, the point B. I mean the joint B is connecting the point A as well as point C. So I'm writing it as BA, BC. Initially you need to calculate the stiffness. How to calculate the stiffness? The value of stiffness, if the far end is from the B to A, I'm seeing B is the near end and A is the far end. If the far end is fixed with respect to B, then the stiffness matrix, stiffness will be 4EI divided by L, which is equal to 4EI divided by how much? The length is 4, 4, 4 gets cancelled. And here the stiffness is EI. Next, for BC, forehand is what we can see in case of BC is the forehand is hinged. You can see at the point C is hinged, since the forehand, which is C, which since it is hinged, the stiffness will be 3EI by L, which is equal to 3EI by 3, 3, 3 gets cancelled, it comes to be EI. So after finding this value, the next chart here is summation of K, the total stiffness, that is EI plus EI, it comes to be 2EI. 2EI is the total stiffness with respect to this. Then after calculating this value, I need to find the distribution factor. The distribution factor, the value for distribution factor is equal to K divided by summation of K. Is it fine? So for the value BA, what is the value of K here? The value of K is EI. EI divided by summation of K is how much? 2EI. EI, EI gets cancelled, half. Again here also same thing, EI divided by 2EI, which is equal to half. The distribution factor for BA is equal to half and BC is equal to half. These are the two things which is very important for finding out the final moments. From the first step, we have calculated the fixed end moment. Later, we have calculated the distribution factor by drawing a chart. So after calculating this, we need to find the value of the final moments. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to draw the third method to find the final moment. Here, I'm just drawing the structure like this. With respect to this structure, let me take this as a point A. This is a point B and this is point C. I'm just drawing a line like this. Okay. In the first step, I'm going to write the distribution factor. Distribution factor for BA is how much? 1 by 2. Again, the distribution factor for BC is 1 divided by 2. Then I would like to write the fixed end moment, which I have calculated here. Minus 16, 16, minus 4.4, I mean 8.89. That I am going to add it here. For a point A, fixed end moment, for a point A, what is the fixed end moment which is given? The fixed end moment is for point A is equal to minus 16. Here plus 16. For moment at for BA is 16, BC is again minus 4.4 and here it is 8.89. Okay, one thing you need to consider here is the given thing at a point A is fixed, but at a point C it is hinged. Since the point C is hinged, the hinged point will not carry moment. It will carry the vertical force as well as horizontal force, but in case of moment it will not carry moment. So I need to make moment at a point C will is equal to 0. So what I am going to do, minus 8.89. I am deducting the same value for a point C so that the moment is becoming 0. So after finding out this, since we have deducted with this, we need to carry over this moment here. The carry over factor with respect to this is half, then it comes to be minus 4.44. Okay, so this is the column which is carry over moment. Carry over moment with respect to far end is fixed. You need to consider this point B, since it is an intermediate point. You need to consider this as a fixed. The carry over factor, I am carrying this moment from here to here, which comes to be minus 4.44. So the final, now the total moment here at a point C, it should be 0. I am making it as 0. Here if you add these two things, it comes to be 8.84. then again same thing, 16 minus 16. Is it fine? So the next step is, next step is very simple. That is 16 minus 8.84. This has to be multiplied with the distribution factor, but you have to take it my distribution factor in terms of minus. Then here also 16 minus 8.84. It has to be multiplied with the distribution factor of half of the negative distribution factor. That is the rule. You need to sum up these two things, whatever may be the sign. Since the minus sign is present here, 16 minus, if it was plus, you would have considered here plus only. 16, since it is minus, I am making minus, but the distribution factor has to be multiplied with this thing in the opposite sign. Since the distribution factor is in positive, you need to multiply it with the negative sign. So if you calculate this thing, it comes to be minus 3.58. here also the same value, it comes to be minus 3.58. next I am going to carry this moment. If carry over moment, if the far end is fixed, it is divided away. This is half of this value, it comes to be minus 1.79. next, what is the carry over factor if the far end is hinged? Carry over factor is 0 if the far end is fixed, so it comes to be 0 here. I mean, you are not supposed to carry any moment. So after this, the final moment you'll get in such a way that you need to add the values, that is adding these two values, minus 16 plus of minus 1.79, it comes to be minus 17.79. here I am adding 16 minus 3.58. I am adding these two things, which comes to be plus 12.42. again here this 8.84 has to be deducted with this, since both are minus sign, it comes to be minus 12.42. of course you can see the proof, since this end is hinged, hinge will not carry any moment, it comes to be 0. So these are the final moments which was obtained with respect to the condition that was which was asked in the question. To find the final moment, we have found the final moment. This is moment at AB, final moment at BA, final moment at BC, and final moment at CB is 0, because since it is a hinged support, hinged support is not going to carry any kind of moments. Let me move to the next question. Fixed end moment at a fixed end of the propped cantilever beam due to concentrated load P at a distance A from the fixed end, as shown in the figure which is given below. So with respect to this, I need to calculate fixed ends. OK, I need to calculate the fixed end moment at the proper cantilever beam. How to calculate fixed end moment? It is very simple. I'm going to draw this same diagram here. It is a hinge. One end is fixed and other end is hinged. This kind of structure is called as proper cantilever beam, where a unit load P is acting at a point A from here. It is not exactly acting at a point at the center. This is at a distance B. What is the point of contraflexion in case of proper cantilever beam? Please comment me in the comment section. What is the number of point of contraflexure that can be obtained with respect to proper cantilever beam? How many point of contraflexure? Please comment me in the comment section. It will be a good revision for you. Let me take this point as point A. This point is point B, and I need to calculate the fixed end moment. Okay, so with respect to the condition, what will be the moment at this point? The moment which is developed at the point A, the moment, fixed end moment at a point A, is minus PA B square divided by L square, which we have already known. At a point B, it is plus P A B square divided by L square. But here I mean initially I'm considering the structure like this. Okay, don't get confused. You know, to avoid your confusion, at this point I'm taking it as fixed, just to write the value. Okay, by considering the fixed end support, I'm going to write the fixed end moments with respect to this, which is fixed end moment at a point A and point B. But now I am converting this fixed end beam to a hinged end, and I know hinge will not carry any kind of moment, so I am making P minus of PA B square divided by L square. So the total final end moment at this point, it will become zero. That is what I need to make. Now I need to carry this moment. So the carryover moment will be, if the far end is fixed, the carryover factor will be half. I am carrying it into, it comes to be minus PA B square divided by 2L square. If I substitute this, what happens? Moment at a point A, which is equal to minus PA B square divided by L square, again minus P B A square divided by L square. I am taking minus sign outside, minus PA B by L square into B plus A by 2, which is equal to minus PA B by L square. I am adding these two things, which becomes 2B plus A divided by 2, which is equal to minus PA B by, I'm taking this 2 outside, 2L square into 2B plus A. I can write it as L plus B. So PAB divided by 2L square into L plus B. So according to this, option A will be the right answer. See, very simple thing. Just initially consider the structure as fixed end support. Write the fixed end moment. Since the hinge will not carry any moment, just cancel it up and carry the moment, the total moment at a point A, with respect to some of the calculations, you can obtain this answer. This would be the right answer for this question. Yes, this is very simple question. A two-span continuous beam of ABC. They are telling two-span continuous beam of ABC. Let me take some point A, then some point B, and some point C. With end A fixed, they are telling end A is fixed. Let me make end A is fixed, and the end C is hinged. This C end is hinged. Is having AB 4 meter and BC 6 meter. The distance between AB is how much? It is 4 meter. Then the BC is equal to 6 meters. inertia of AB with respect to BC is 1 divided by 2. Just remember this. It is subject to a uniformly distributed load of 10 kN for whole span. UDL of 10 kN for the entire right span, over the entire right span, it is carrying a uniformly distributed load of 10 kN per meter, then the moment at a point C, just use your common sense here. What is the moment at a point C? In this question, they have specifically mentioned C is hinged. Okay? C point is hinged. Since C is hinged, hinge will not carry any moment. So, the moment at a point C will be zero. Okay, friends, the remaining question we'll see in the next lecture series. Any queries, please do comment me in the comment section. Join my Telegram channel, which was given in the description. Thank you, one and all. Bye-bye.